Hey friends, welcome back to Homemade Homestead. My name is Rachel if you're new around here, and today I did a stock up haul. Our local grocery store does a two-day sale, Fridays and Saturdays. So I usually try to go Friday morning. I was a little later today. I went to the store at 11 and they were already out of some stuff, and it's all wall supplies left. These are my favorite sales to hit up because I feel like they're cheaper than Walmart. So this is when I tend to stock up on things that we just use on a regular basis. And I'm also looking forward here to the late summer, early fall time. The baby is due around that time, and so I want to make sure that I have some things on hand that I can make freezer meals, because that is a lifesaver. If you have never made freezer meals, if you're about to have a baby or something like that, I highly encourage it, because you know, even if we have family and friends that come over and help me, it's so nice not to have to worry about dinner. You know, they can throw in something from the freezer into the oven, or I can ask my husband to thaw out something for the crock pot. So it is so convenient to have freezer meals, so I am definitely gonna do that. I've done that with my last two babies, and I'm gonna do it with this fourth. I didn't know about it with my first, so it's good to know though. So I was thinking a little bit ahead for that. That's why I bought some of these items, but let me show you what great deals that I found today. Okay, so here is kind of an overview look. I know it looks like we're crazy people that we go through so many chips, but we really don't. I just love having them on hand. They make awesome taco salads, or my homemade Cafe Rio, which is a local restaurant, which is kind of like a taco salad, but it's quite a bit different actually. Or nachos, haystacks. I love having chips on hand. It's just an easy throw together meal. So I did get 15 bags total. One of our favorite kinds is actually this Mexican style. They only had one bag left. They had 14 bags of the Southwest style. They also had like some that were seasoned, which I try to stay away from. They have a lot of MSG in it, but you know, I also have Doritos over here, so everything we take with like a grain of salt. But here I just wanted some plain tortilla chips to make all those different recipes I talked about, and I just love having these on hand. The expiration date is the end of June, so right now we're into April, so that's about 2 months, and I think we will go through those in that amount of time. And we'll just, you know, expiration dates I try to be careful with, but they're not always like hard and fast rules. So I think we'll have them done in 2 months, but anyway, these were $1.67 or $1.66 a bag. It's $3 for $5. So that is why I chose to get 15 bags. So they stayed with that 3-to-5 ratio, $3 for $5. And then I only got one jug of La Victoria salsa. This is in the medium. We actually make a lot of our own homemade tomato products because we grow a lot from our garden. I like to bottle in the fall. We do a lot of salsa, spaghetti sauce, all that, you know, stewed tomatoes, juice, all that stuff with tomato products. But I thought it'd be fun to try a different salsa. We're huge chips and salsa fans, so that'll be another great snack to have. But I restrained. I only bought one, and this was $3.99. And yeah, talking about MSG, of course, I did get Doritos. Since we are going into summertime here, we like to grill. And when I grill, I don't know why, I feel like you need to have chips on the side. If it's with burgers, hot dogs, even grilled chicken, like I feel like chips are just one of those things that has to go with grilled food. So my husband's favorite is the Cool Ranch. I like Cool Ranch too, but I also like the nacho cheese every once in a while. So I only got one bag of the nacho cheese, and I got 5 bags of the Doritos. Now this deal was 3 for $5 as well, and so I did 6, and they let me have one of these and 5 of the other flavors. This was a great deal too. I mean, the same price, but these are smaller bags. These bags are 9 1/4 ounces, where the tortilla chips are actually 18 ounces. They're quite big bags. Now, the only thing I was really bummed about is tortillas. They had these tortillas on for 79 cents, which is a huge markdown. It's a great stock up price. And they had only one package left when I got there. And so I did grab this 8 count of the bigger burrito size. They also had the 10 count of the smaller size, but they were out of those as well. And if they had more, I would have definitely stocked up, but oh well, you know, you win some, you lose some. I was hoping to get these because I love to freeze breakfast burritos, bean and cheese burritos,
enchiladas. There's so many things that you can make with tortillas and freeze, and that's one of my favorite things to do, but that's okay. I'll just watch for more sales. We still have a lot of time, so I did just pick up one of these for 79 cents. Now I got some enchilada sauce. These are the big 28 ounce cans. I know you can make enchilada sauce from scratch. I've never tried it. So if you guys have a great recipe on how to make homemade enchilada sauce, either green or red, please let me know down in the comment section, because I would love to try to make it homemade. This does have some extra ingredients in it. It doesn't have wheat flour, which I know some of them do. I am gluten-free, so I try to watch for that. But I did get 6 can of the green mild enchilada sauce. I'm gonna use this for enchilada soup, also just regular enchiladas, and for freezer meals and all that. And then I also got 2 cans of the red enchilada sauce, I think. Oh no, 3 cans. 3 cans of the red enchilada sauce. This is mild as well. And I'm gonna use this again in an enchilada recipe. Let me know. I usually go towards the green, not the red sauce. So if you have a favorite enchilada recipe, please leave a comment down below, because I'd love to hear your guys' favorite recipes. So these were on sale for $1.50 a can, which I thought that was a great price for a 28 ounce can, $1.50. And I did get 6 and 3, so 9 cans of those. And the expiration date is until 2022, towards the very end of the year. So these should work great for us. Now back here, I kind of went potato crazy. They had these Idaho potatoes. They are 5 pounds of potatoes, and they had them on for 99 cents. Like, that is just such a great deal. They look great. And I got 7 bags of that. So 35 pounds of russet potatoes. My hope for these is mashed potatoes that I freeze, which works out perfectly well. I've done it several times. I just totally make up like normal mashed potatoes, freeze them in a gallon-sized Ziploc bag, and then when I go to make it, I let it thaw for a little bit, pop it into a pan, and it cooks up perfectly. Also, I love to use these potatoes to make shepherd's pie, and we have goat from our goats that we raised, so I can make true shepherd's pie. I usually make cottage pie with beef, so I'm excited to do that with goat this year. So I bought so many potatoes. I spent $7 on 35 pounds of potatoes, which I thought was a great deal. And also, I've seen people make like twice baked potatoes and freeze them too. There's so many different recipes that I could make and freeze them. So that's what I was thinking with the potatoes, because I know they don't last a ton of time when they're in your pantry. They start to grow and stuff. So I was thinking mashed potatoes, shepherd's pie, maybe twice baked potatoes. So yeah, something like that. That's what I was hoping for these potatoes.
And also, I stocked up on 2 more items. Now, during the pandemic, you might have seen restaurants or even grocery stores selling like big bags of the items. I saw a lot with restaurants because they were trying to still make money when their restaurants had to be closed. So they would sell like 50 pound bags of rice or 50 pound bags of flour and oats. When I found that out, I contacted a local bakery and I asked if they were doing that, and they still are doing that where I am. And so I was able to buy a 50 pound bag of oats and a 50 pound bag of flour. So if you guys are still trying to find things at a really good price, I encourage you to just call around and ask. Maybe check bakeries. Sometimes grocery stores will do it, but, and this is like not the stuff that they normally put out on the shelf. These are like, you know, that they're ordering in to make stuff, and so they can sell it at a pretty good price. So let me show you those 2 bags.
Right here, we got a 50 pound bag of organic whole wheat flour. This is already ground, but we go through it pretty quickly, especially if we make homemade bread. This is what we use. So 50 pounds of organic whole wheat flour. And then in this bag, we got another 50 pound bag of rolled oats. Not the quick oats, but rolled oats. So both of these 2 bags together was $53, and they did charge tax on this, and so it came over like a little bit over $54 for both bags.
So all in all, I spent a little bit over $100 on stocking up on things that I feel like we're gonna use, especially looking forward to like freezer meals. And I mean, those bulk items will last us quite a long time. That flour, we don't go through it as quickly, but it's great to have on hand for homemade bread. Those potatoes, I'm super excited about. And even the splurge items of chips. You know, they're not necessities, but we definitely will enjoy them over the summer. Well, thank you guys so much for coming along with me on this stock up haul. I hope you're finding some amazing deals. It's so hard to leave great deals behind. So give this video a thumbs up if you love sales too. And I hope you're having an awesome day wherever you are. We'll talk to you again real soon. Bye-bye now.